evening and welcome to Tinkering with Etkelar. As I had a minor setback with my current mechanical project, I had to improvise a shorter, yet again, lab-related one. The mechanical project will be coming up eventually, you can count on it. Some of you might recall that I made myself an improvised AC power supply for testing mains-powered devices from a car battery and an inverter. The reason was that I could not find any affordable lab isolation transformers. They all were 600 euro and up and up and up. I'm still rather proud of it and it has served me quite well. But charging the battery for hours and running out of battery during testing was quite annoying. Lo and behold, during another random eBay search, I found an untested 4-parts model that came for only a bit over 200 euro, including shipping. I couldn't resist, and you know what's coming up next. My biggest worry was that the item wouldn't include the main part, the transformer, and was an empty shell. But when it arrived and weighed in at about 13 kilograms, I was confident that it was at least mostly complete. The listing showed a missing power switch. Well, I guess I found it inside. What's really missing is the nut that holds it in place. Disassembling was a bit complicated. Not because of the construction, but because of the weight. I couldn't easily see how the screws connected the parts, so I started off on the wrong foot. Turns out that the backside of the case is a shell that lifts off and the front panel should remain connected to the inside parts, not the other way around. I use a roll of duct tape to prop up the unit when I have to put it face down. That way, nothing gets bent. I did not expect the Variac to have a roller. That's a novel idea and keeps the wear down on the coils. But over time, quite a bit of dust has collected all over the inside of the device, because the roller is made from carbon. The device contains the two primary parts in that toroidal transformer thingy. The actual transformer and a Variac combined into one unit. A Variac alone doesn't provide isolation, but I checked, there is nothing connected between the mains input side and the output. Uh-oh, the Variac has taken some damage during its life. It seems that the meter is a bit too close to the windings and when the device takes a hit, like in transport, they slam together. You might want to check yours too. I took out the soldering iron and added a bit of tin on the scuffed wires, just to increase the current capabilities. The damaged section does have a slightly reduced diameter after all. And yes, I did scrape out any solder between the windings and covered the spot with some lacquer. The case was a bit on the rough side, but after sanding it to remove any rust crust and bending some kinks into shape again, I went over it with a direct on rust paint. Nice and simple, almost exactly the same color even. The switch gets some good cleaning too. I decided to open it not just because of the cleaning, but also because it may have had issues that led to its current lost on the inside state, but it turns out to be just fine. I would have loved to give that meter glass a good cleaning from the inside, but somebody decided to pot the meter into that metal frame. So no, a good scrub from the outside only it is then. The outlet is a predecessor of the Schuko system, just without that. I have no idea what they would have been called, but Schuko is an abbreviation of Schutzkontakt, literally protection contact, and it refers to the earth pin specifically. These ones don't have that, so just the plug? They were common back in the day before GFIs. There is still one in the wall behind the stage. Greasing up the Variac axle and attaching the slider, roller again. I replaced the old power cord with a new one. It might have sufficed, but it looked crusty and had the US plug on it. And time for a first check. Woohoo! It works! And the meter is spot on. I like it. To properly paint the case, I had to remove the rubber feet. A bit of silicone oil for cleaning makes them nice and shiny again. They were riveted, but I think I can get away with some M4 screws too. Plenty of empty space inside. The power switch is missing the outside nut, but the inside one is still there, so I repurposed it until I can find a decent replacement. The switch just sticks out a bit too far, but other than that, it's just fine. And here comes the case. I had to desolder the power cord again to pass it through on the back. And now I see that one of the rubber feet is exactly underneath the large inner frame, and that means my screw and nut replacement for the rivets doesn't fit. Oof. I just used a countersunk screw from the inside and put the nut on the outside for the offending one. Now it fits again. The knob has also taken a beating. It originally had a small cap, but that has broken off. Another case for OpenSCAD. The factory sticker was worn badly. I removed it before the paint job and decided to remake it. A bit of tweaking and selecting close matches for the fonts later, I have a nice printable version. To get the same look as the original, I got myself some aluminium tape, cut it to size, and then attached a water slide decal print on top. Not 100% perfect, of course, but really, really close and much better than the frailed original. I used my set of punch numbers to reapply the serial number and voltage rating. And now some info. The RT-3 model here was made by Grundig and appeared in catalogs of the late 1959 timeframe. It can be switched between 110 and 220 volt line voltage and supports up to 300 VA for 90 to 250 volts and 3 amps for 0 to 90 volt output. Should work fine for the things I have to test. And if I want a current limiting feature, I'll add a bulb in series to get my very own isolation transformer current limited Variac supply. So, what do you think? Did it clean up okay? The faceplate still has a few blemishes, but since the print is fine, I think that anything I do would just make it worse. Besides, you can only see them from the correct angle. And that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. See you next time! Lo and behold, during another random eBay search, I found a unused, untested